subscribe to our channel now and press the bell icon to never miss an update from KIMS Global.
Hi, I'm Dr. Suresh Chandran, Chief Coordinator and Senior Consultant Neurologist, Department of Neurology, Kerala Institute of Medical Sciences, Trivandrum. Parkinsonism, we have a medical treatment option, a surgical treatment option, and definitely supportive therapy. Medications, as I said, the primary problem with idiopathic Parkinson's disease is the lack of the chemical neurotransmitter called as dopamine. So when there is a deficiency of a thing, we have to supplement it. So the medical treatment depends or primarily focused on supplementing dopamine or dopamine-like compounds. So we do have compounds like syndopa, which is the dopamine, and there are dopamine agonists, which are compounds which are similar to DOPA, acting on the same receptors. There are multiple medicines like dopamine agonists. There are a lot of medicines, rohypnol, pramipexole, amantadine. Then again, we do have medications for tremor, like anticholinergics, beta blockers we sometimes use for tremor. So we do have an array of medical options. Medications is the first line of Parkinson's disease management. Equally important for is the supportive therapy. And when it comes to supportive therapy, physiotherapy is a very important aspect of treatment of Parkinson's disease, because the patients have a lot of stiffness of the bodies, a lot of postural instability, they do have problems with the balance. So physiotherapy holds an important part of the treatment of Parkinson's disease, where we can reduce the stiffness, improve the mobility, improve the gait, improve the balance. Also, other aspects of supportive therapy will be the nutritional aspect. Many of them do have psychological issues, maybe psychotherapy, counseling, then gait training, toileting aspects. So a whole lot of occupational and physiotherapy also is as important as medical therapy. Surgical options we do consider when the medical therapy fails. That is mostly in the advanced cases of Parkinson's disease. And the most prevalent or the most widely used surgical management nowadays is the DBS, what we call the deep brain stimulation. In a simple way, I can tell you that we insert some electrodes into the brain, and electrical signals are carefully delivered to the brain, which are controllable and programmable from outside. In a simple way, I can put it in that this is almost like a pacemaker, where you insert a pacemaker into the heart and you give electrical impulses, and which are programmable and controllable. So deep brain stimulation is the most common or most widely used surgical management nowadays. Other options we do have are something for the tremor, like thalamotomy, and transplantation of fetal dopamine containing cells or etc. also can be tried. But the most used and most approved surgical option is deep brain stimulation.